Hello everyone. In this lecture, we can learn about the user datagram protocol. What is meant by user datagram protocol? So the user datagram protocol, in short, we will call as UDP, and it is a simple datagram oriented protocol. And this belongs to the transport layer protocol, and this UDP, its speciality comes in the way that is, it is a connectionless protocol. So basically you need to understand that this is a connectionless unreliable protocol. So why we say that it is unreliable? Because there is no flow control, there is no flow control mechanism, and there is no error recovery procedure. And because of these things, we can say that the UDP is a connectionless and unreliable protocol. And UDP is said to be an unreliable protocol in the way that, comparable to the reliable transport protocol, here we can able to follow a best effort delivery mechanism. And in UDP, the receiver does not generate any acknowledgement, so the sender no need to wait for any kind of acknowledgement for the packet sent. So this shortcoming makes this protocol unreliable as well as easier on processing. So in a simple way, we can say that user datagram protocol help us to take the data very fast without delay from the sender to the receiver. So why do we need such a kind of unreliable protocol? So here we deploy the UDP, where the acknowledgement packets share significant amount of the bandwidth. For example, in video streaming or in sending n number of packets from one place to another, and for every packet sent, if you keep a method like getting the acknowledgement for every data packets being received on the receiving side, it will be difficult for us to maintain the band space because it will occupy huge amount of bandwidth. So in one way we can say that we are wasting the bandwidth. So in order to overcome this type of method drawbacks, we will be using this UDP. Even though it is unreliable, and by deploying the best effort service, we can able to implement. Now let us see some of the features of the UDP. So here the UDP is used when acknowledgement of the data does not hold any significance. So that means in some applications where we doesn't need the acknowledgement from the receiver, there and all we can apply UDP. Also, UDP is a protocol for data flow in one direction very effectively, and it is simple and also suitable for query based communication, and it is not connection oriented, and there is no option for congestion control mechanism, and there is no guarantee that the sent data will be get received. And UDP is suitable protocol for streaming applications like voice over IP and multimedia streaming. Now you are looking on the UDP header, and the UDP header we are having 20 bytes for the IP header, and the UDP header has 8 bytes. And apart from this, it is having the source port address, destination port address, and UDP length, and also the UDP checksum. So the source port, this will be 16 bits information which will be used to identify the port, and destination port, it also 16 bit, and based on the application level to get identified, and the length field specify the entire length of the UDP, and it will be 16 bits, and minimum its value will be 8 byte. and checksum. This field stores the checksum value generated by the sender before sending, and based on the protocol type such as IPv4, we can able to implement this. So when checksum field does not contain any value, it is made zero and all its bits are set to zero. That is a kind of procedure we follow in order to identify the error in this type of data flow. And coming to the application side of UDP, and UDP will be deployed with domain name space or domain name service, then simple network management protocol. This also can be used in trivial file transfer protocol. This also can be used with routing information protocol. And apart from this, UDP checksum plays a main role. And here the checksum calculation has three sections. One is pseudo header, UDP header, and the data coming from the application layer. So what is pseudo header? Pseudo header is the part of the header of the IP packet in which the user datagram is to be encapsulated with some fields filled with zero. So in the pseudo header takes on values so that we can able to form the datagram frame, and it will be enabled to deliver the data without any kind of errors. So here you can able to view the overall structure of the UDP header, including the pseudo headers. So one side part we have the pseudo header, and another side part we are having the header, as we learned previously. So that's all in this lecture today.